Hey YouTube, what's up? This is Ben from the Be a Photographer channel, and in this video I want to share with you some tips for getting proper white balance and also adjusting your white balance in Capture One Pro 20. As you can see, the two images on screen were shot within 30 seconds of one another with the same camera and same lighting setups, yet the backgrounds look vastly different. You'll notice the skin is different as well. On the left side we have more of a mango peachy background with warmer skin tones, and on the right side we have a more true to life pink background with cooler skin tones, and that is because the white balance when I was on automatic white balance mode changed, but the beauty of shooting it raw means we can change the white balance in our editing software, and here I'm using Capture One Pro 20. Now if we take a look at my living room studio, you'll notice that the actual background is more like the one on the right, and it's more pink in real life. But I honestly like the kind of peachy color here on the left, and I'll show you how to match images in Capture One Pro 20. Now the first thing, let's take a look at the white balance slider. So you can see these are both set to shot, and you can see the first image is at 5700 Kelvin, and the second image is at 4700 Kelvin. So there's a little bit of a difference there. Now what's cool is we have multiple options for this. Again, we have our automatic adjustment button, so we can hit automatic adjustment here. You can hit automatic adjustment here, and you can see they actually got really close now just based off the automatic adjustment, and I think Capture One did a great job. It put the tint at 0.1 on this image, negative 0.1, so that's almost negligible, and the difference is within 60 Kelvin meter points, or whatever you'd like to call them. The other thing is you can also set a custom white balance by simply sliding to the left or the right, or using one of the modes here. So for anything in studio, or if you shot an event with flash, you can just press flash, and then we'll go to the other image and also set that to flash. And you can see now we have the same white balance between the two images. If I brought them up side by side, there we go. They look perfect, nice and quick. You can also, of course, manually control this. So we can slide to the left to make the image more blue if we want to give it cooler tones. And then we can slide to the right if we want to give the image warmer tones. So again, you can just slide left for blue and colder tones, and right for warmer tones. And again, if we use the layer mask, we could adjust just the background or just the skin, and we'll do this in another video. Tint is going to be more on the skin tones, I'd say. So if we slide to the left, we'll see we get a lot more green. And of course, it still affects the background, but I see that tint usually affects the brighter areas a little bit more. And if we go to the right, it's going to add more pinkish hues. And so if you're trying to adjust the skin tones and do some fine tuning, you can adjust there. So again, I'm going to go to flash, and then I'm going to slide the tint right there on the right, just barely. And then I can sync those up between the two. Now, the last option and the tip that I recommend is using a gray card. This is a gray card. It costs less than $10. It folds up small enough to fit in the palm of your hand, and it's really handy for getting your white balance 100% perfect. This is especially useful when you have a lot of colors going on in your photos and when you want to use the color picker tool to set the proper white balance in your shots. Now, how does this work? First, let's take an image right here with the Z6. And you can see that the colors look a little bit off. They're fairly close, but if I slide this over and we see more of the tic-tacs, you'll see the colors aren't perfect. They're a little bit too cool looking for my eye. Now what's nice is we can just pop this gray card into the background or really any part of the image, take it, and then using the color picker tool in Capture One Pro 20 in the white balance tab, we can click on the center of the gray card or any part of the gray card really, and we'll get the perfect white balance. You can see I did this on my photo shoot with Desanka, where I had her hold this card at the beginning of the shoot, and that way I could just set the white balance from that shot for every other shot I did in the series because the lighting did not change. Now another good trick, and the best way to use this actually, is on set. So for those that are filming video, you know you can't change white balance nearly as easily as you can with raw photography. So what you do is you grab your gray card and set your camera to that white balance. So to do this, you want to go into your white balance settings, however you get there depending on your camera. All cameras have this option. And then we're going to go into custom white balance. So for this one, I'm going to go to preset manual, and then I'm going to hit measure mode. So when I tap that, I can select on the gray card. And you can see now my white balance is perfect, and this gray is a perfect 50% gray. Now when I remove it, if I were to take an image of the Tic Tacs, it'll come out perfect straight out of camera. You can see we zoom in here, and if I bring the Tic Tacs up to the monitor, you can see the colors are almost spot on. I just have to change my exposure a little bit, and we can get the perfect Tic Tac image. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more tutorials, and let me know what you want to learn in the next one by leaving a comment below.